What's up, everybody? It's time for game 2 of Agony Kinjo versus
Chiparek.
Yeah.
You know, for a second in your intro, you sounded like Borat.
The hell? Alright, so thoughts? Previous battle?
I guess the ninja usage could have been a lot better. I mean, just sending your units alone, isolated from your cav force. I mean, if you look at... I really don't want to bring up old matches, but if you look at my match against Swift, for example, I used stealth and then I charged, but he didn't use stealth or charged at all. He just sat there throwing his bombs. Plus, he suicided one ninja into a bunch of match locks, and that's also an unheard strategy that I've never seen before. But still... If you want to do that against me, y'all can. But, I mean, I can understand that there's too much chaos, and ninjas require a lot of micro to use, and he spaced them all across his opponent's army, so it's understandable if he makes a couple of mistakes. But he did cause a lot of disorganization. He did catch Kinjo off guard. Maybe if he committed his infantry a lot quicker on that same front, instead of going across the river attacking his opponent's... entire army, basically, he was attacking those spear walls from the front. Maybe if he attacked on the flank and kept on flanking, then that would have done something.
Yeah.
Those Yeriash wouldn't take that kind of pressure. They would rout with enemies on their flanks. That would cause Kinjo to disorganize his lines. That would cause his matchlocks to probably shoot into the back of his own units. His general would have probably been open. His cav on the other flank. There's so many options. I can only suggest and I can only talk and think about what would or what could happen. But, I mean, I guess it all depends if you were in that situation.
I'm sorry, can you repeat that?
I recorded that. I'll repeat it after we're done with this. After it's posted on YouTube. Alright, so it looks like Kinjo is going to bring Nodachi this round. It looks like he's going to rush. First, he's going to go for the Sword Dojo. Kind of obvious. I think his opponent might go for a Skirmish Base. Maybe Match Like Warrior Monks, Naginata Attendants, and Katana Samurai for Gerudo players so far. This Katana Sam, 18 melee attack. He doesn't have Blade Master, does he?
You know, Chibarek's infantry is very weak if you look at the stats.
Yeah, because... 20 clan tokens for the extra 2 melee attack. Yeah, one of them has 16 attack. These are really weak Katana Sam. One, it has 12 morale, 12 melee attack. He doesn't have many spear units, so he's going to be constantly harassed by those cav of Kinjo, and I think Kinjo did bring bow cav.
Yes, he's shooting at him now.
Great guard cav, they're kind of isolated. I wouldn't take the bait though, I wouldn't rush. I think the Gerudo player might rush anyway. I don't know why I'm saying this, but... Seeing those bocav really does cause, like, you bring bocav, for example.
His archers, man. Why is he not stuck? I was wondering why he could have shot a long time ago.
Kinjo's splitting up his force, he's going to make a flanking force, and it looks like the Gerudo player is going to have to fight on two fronts here. He's probably going to have to split up his force. Maybe he should attack that flanking force right now with his full army, because I would rather do that.
It looks like a cave attack. Yeah, Yarikav charge.
Gonna be stopping those Naginata attendants. Oh, those matchups are wide open. They need to be charged. Oh! Nice! They try to use the increased range, but that doesn't increase your reload or nothing. Doesn't help you shoot faster. Oh, and those Naginata attendants are gonna... The Yarikav of the Druida player looks like he was about to countercharge, but no, that Yarikav is gonna stay there and get taken out. Now it looks like Kinjo is going to close in. He's moving in through the forest. He's going to get a lot of cover there. He doesn't have to worry about that great card. Cav right now, it's pinned down with those Yeri Cav of his. And what else is happening? Looks like he's going to pretty much sandwich the Gerudo player's army here.
This is I think this is going to be a giant pudding here, I swear.
Yeah, this is going to be a quick match, honestly. But those Nodachi are really dangerous. I mean, look at the melee attack. 24 melee attack against, like, 18 attack. 19 attack Katana Samurai. Okay, this is going to be devastating. I'm going to get down close. Oh, my God, that is devastating. Already down the 59, 57 out of 80. Those Nodachi have like 70 out of 80. They didn't take virtually no damage. Both players have rallied their forces. Warcry has been dropped down on Kinjo's troops. And these are Yeriash, Nodachi Sam, and Naginata attendants. And I don't think they're going to be routing because these are very powerful units. Even the Yeriash of Kinjo has 10 melee attack, 20 for bonus versus cavalry, 13 melee defense, and 8 morale. And they're killing a lot. Oh, and he's taking a cavalry charge by Kinjo. His general's in danger. Looks like Kinjo's going to attack the back of these units, and he might cause them to rout. Yep, close to. Yep. And I think Kinjo's going to go 2-0 with this match.
He's Budinke, man.
Matchlock fire. Daki Samurai giving off some nice shots as well, but those Nodachi Samurai already in melee with those Matchlock Warrior Monks, they're not going to give off any more devastating fire. Looks like Kinjo is going to send a cavalry charge, the Yeri cavalry, into the blob of these units. I don't know if that's really going to stop them. There is some highly upgraded Yeriash in there as well. Man, I need some Yeriash like that. All his units are like so heavily upgraded. I mean, it's like, how do you beat that? I don't even think, I don't even know if the guy's Katana Sam could beat those Yeriash.
There's no way.
I mean, Kinjo did split up his forces. Even as strong as his units are, you really do have to use them tactically, and he did. So I think that's really why he won this battle, because the Gerudo players' units are still in this match, still fighting, and it is coming out a lot closer than it was in the first match. It looks like Kinjo's general is about to rout. He's wavering. I don't know if he will. Actually, what happened to his general in the first place? How is it about to rout? Yeah, his general has routed. Uh-oh. Are we going to see a comeback?
No.
Are we going to see a comeback?
No. If it happened,
I mean, you never know. You never know. That surprising feat happens sometimes. I mean, the battle instantly turns. I mean, that would be nice. I mean, I do want to see a third match going.
No.
2-0. GG to both players. Nice. I mean, we can all look at this battle and just say, okay, what is Kinjo's weakness here? What is his weakness? Let's study this.
If I were Tiporek, what I would have done is I would have taken my force. I would have screened his force with his general and committed most of my troops to the right flank. Because his general is not there.
Yeah.
So they are going to waver faster.
Yeah, that's basically the weakness that Kinjo has, because his general is only on one flank.
Yeah, I said that early. He should focus on that one. Those units of Kinjo that were crossing in the forest would also... He didn't have any cast superiority. I mean, he had to deal with Bokev as well, so if he would have just attacked that force like Yael said, where the general wasn't, he would have routed them. Plus, since they're fighting in the trees, he can negate any rear cavalry attacks that Kinjo might do to him, but he just didn't react well. I mean, if you look at a force on two of your fronts, how do you react quick enough to that? I mean, that's, like, stunning. You don't see many people do that much. Alright, Agony Kinjo... He deployed 1,070, he lost 705, he killed 862. Kepriak, he deployed 940, he lost 865, he killed 705. GG.